If you're feeling alone or misunderstood, there's an escape, and metal is that escape. You can go find a place and feel at home inside the music, and a festival like this is the place to go to.
Metal is life.
It's a huge place with like the metal community coming together.
We're here for Black Sabbath.
Coming to see Black Sabbath, of course.
Black Sabbath brought me here.
All day long, Sabbath.
Whee!
I'm here to see Slayer!
Maranatha's Beast.
I've probably seen at least 100 concerts at this venue. I've never seen it this packed before. I've never seen the parking lots go all the way past the freeway.
It's great to see the diversity of people.
There's kids here, there's old people here, there's a lot of stoners here, there's a lot of metalheads here.
As soon as I could buy tickets, I did. I spent like $600 to take my daughter to Ozfest.
Ain't nothing better than being in the desert with a bunch of metalheads either.
On acid.
Allie's a pretty big metalhead over here, so we're here for Megadeth too. We're here for all of it.
You can see so many different kinds of bands and different kinds of music all at one event.
We've met tons of people. Everyone's great, everyone's nice, everyone's friendly.
We're a small group of people, but we love it and we love each other.
Everyone's just having a good time and being themselves.
That's right.
We are the mosh pit.
We are a mosh pit.
We like to hold hands and do a big circle. Swing back and forth.
Three people start dancing and then everyone just gets into it.
That was special for me. It saved my life.
I'm showing my respects to the genre, the music that has gotten me through all the hard times.
And I know a lot of these people feel the same way. And like 1,000 years from now, they'll be, if the world exists still, there'll be metalheads and there'll be kids who need it and live off metal and can't survive without it. And the people we're seeing on stage tonight are the people we have to thank for that. The original people who made metal, who they didn't grow up with metal, they just invented it out of their ass. Any other metal band from now on for the rest of the days will attribute everything they have to these bands, the first metal bands ever.
It's an escape from the everyday life, definitely.
I've never seen them. I've been listening to them since I was like 14 or something. My first guitar teacher gave me volume 4.
I've been going to shows since I was a little kid. My first show was AC/DC and Deep Purple at the Long Beach Arena way back in the day. It was like 1975, and then Black Sabbath, and I've been to everything.
I'm just glad to be in a place where we have a lot of metal music.
It's probably like my 30-something time seeing Slayer. Just gets better every time.
Every time I see somebody on stage, I just wish I was up there too.
Maybe you'll see us one day.
I'm only 26, so by the time I'm like 30, none of my favorite bands will exist anymore, so that's why I'll see every concert I can. I'll never miss a show.
But we're just big music fans. We try to go as many shows as we can around here.
The main root of every band here is Black Sabbath.
Between the three of us, we have about one record player. We probably only have like 3-4 Sabbath records, probably about 20 metal records in all, but we play them all day.
I feel fucking super privileged because my dad listened to this when he was my age.
This is what you grew up on. Like,
and he raised us on this.
And our grandparents all grew up on this stuff, all right here from the West Coast. I mean, this is in our genes.
I got into metal just because, you know, when I started listening to it, the feeling that it gave me, I knew it was me. And I've never looked back.
We were definitely born in the wrong age.
Last tour for Black Sabbath, at least that's what they say for now. So I want to show that, you know.
Sabbath.
come on.
We do stuff here. We do things,
right? We do things.
So sorry.
And it's probably one of the like last times Sabbath is gonna fucking tour.
Yeah.
I mean, they're about to fucking drop dead.
Supposedly the end.
I'm just saying,
but
they're fucking old as fuck.
I would have hiked to the top of that mountain and back and over it or wherever I had to go to see Sabbath for their last time.
1,000 years from now, there's not gonna be any of these biblical icons here anymore. Like, these are the disciple times of metal. Like, these are all the people who invented metal. Like, 10 years from now, you're never gonna be able to see a Black Sabbath show. 10 years from now, you're never gonna be able to see a Slayer show ever again for the rest of human time. So you better see it now while you can.
This is it, so I won't have a voice left after the concert.
Metalheads are kind of like outcasts. Even though they're outcasts, they like to feel like they're part of something. And being a metalhead, you're part of something.
Fucking Slayer!
Slayer!
Slayer! Yeah! But yeah, that's why. Because all these people every single day have to go out in that world and be tame and live amongst a bunch of squares and sheep all day, every day. And this is the only time you'll ever be amongst your own people, where you'll be amongst thousands of people that all agree with you and understand you and believe the things you believe, because you'll never get that anywhere else.
It makes me feel like a kid.
First, I just couldn't stand that Trump and Sanders' campaigns were referred to as raging against the machine, that these were anti-establishment candidates running as a Republican, as a Democrat.